I have seen these professional criers. I have a story also. One fellow dies, his wife is sitting and crying. The neighbor lady comes, and along with the crying itself, I'll tell in Tamil, then I'll translate. Because this has to be told in Tamil, then I will translate. இழவு வீட்டுக்காரி உட்கார்ந்துருந்தா, பொணம் கிடக்கு, பக்கத்து வீட்டுக்காரி வர்றா, அது நெடு வீடுன்றதால் தோட்டம் தெரியும், பின்பக்கம் தோட்டம் இருக்கிறது தெரியுது. பக்கத்து வீட்டுக்காரி அழுகும் போதே, இந்த எதிர் வீட்டுக்காரி இங்கே உட்காந்துருக்கா, பக்கத்து வீட்டுக்காரி இங்கே உட்காந்துருக்கா, ஓனர் வீட்டு ஓனர் இங்கே உட்காந்துருக்கா, அந்த அம்மா யார் புருஷன் சுத்து போனால் அவன் உட்காந்துருக்கான், அவன் உட்காந்துருக்கா. அழுகும் போதே இந்த பக்கத்து வீட்டுக்காரி சிக்னல் கொடுக்குறா எதிர் வீட்டுக்காரிக்கு, பந்தாளில பாவக்கா வந்தாளில பாவக்கா. ஆஹா, எதிர் வீட்டுக்காரி சொல்றான், புகையில பார்த்துக்கலாம் புகையில பார்த்துக்கலாம். வீட்டு சொந்தக்காரி சொல்றா, விதைக்கு நான் விட்டு இருக்கேன் விதைக்கு நான் விட்டு இருக்கேன். அந்த டெட் பாடி இஸ் லைங் தேர். Means the owner of the house, her husband is dead, the body is lying. Neighbor house lady is there, opposite house lady is there. This neighbor house lady is giving signal to opposite house lady, hey, look at the garden, there is lot of that bitter gourd hanging, bitter gourd hanging. And the other lady says, when we go we will take care. And the owner is telling that lady, no, 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 I've left it for the seed, don't touch it. And the dead body is lying there. The ruckus they make does not allow you to grasp the lessons death teaches us. The impermanence first time hit my inner space. Please listen. I went and asked my grandmother. Grandmother was rolling. I asked, what do you mean by the word death? Then she said, he has gone to Swami. I told him, Swami na, I'll go to the temple and call him back and bring him. I thought he has gone to the temple. I'll go and bring him back. She said, no, 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 not this Swami, means our temple in our village, he has gone to Sami. I thought Sabarimala was the longest temple I visited in my life in the young age. As a 10-year-old child, the long temple means long, after long travel you will reach a temple, means that is only Sabarimala. That's a place in Kerala. You have to walk around 48 miles, which I did as a 8-year-old child. I walked once that whole thing. So I said, okay, next time when I go, I'll bring him from the temple. She said, no, no, he has gone to the temple. He will never come back at all. So I did not tell anything. Just went and sat in the room. My only problem is now, from tomorrow, who will pluck flowers for me? And who will grind sandal paste for me? And who will protect me and my puja samans from other kids? Who will be doing security job? Only after 2-3 days, it started sinking into me that the impermanence is illusion. Sorry, permanence is illusion. Impermanence is the reality. Listen. It is not a small lesson. All of you would have got this lesson when you faced a death or heard about death. But unfortunately, you did not record it. How many of you are getting it? if you cognize impermanence, you will not be bothered to be authentic and integrated. You will decide, come on, impermanence is life. Let me be integrated and authentic, responsible. As a child, it was a big lesson for me, the lesson of impermanence. I think at least your next generation, don't disturb them or give them the distorted views when they face death. For example, in the house there is some death. Don't tell stories to your next generation. Understand? Allow them to understand impermanence. Don't make a big ruckus of crying, rolling. I tell you, this crying and rolling in powerlessness, that takes away the whole lesson you need to learn from death. How many of you really feel because of the crying and show only you miss the lesson? The second death, that was the shock of my life. In first death, I realized impermanence, means nothing is permanent. Till that day, I was thinking my mother was always how I look at her now. I never understood my mother was young and aged now. I used to think she will be always like this only. So even sometimes when they show the marriage photograph, I'll say, no, this is not you. You don't look like this. This is not you. And once when they showed the marriage photo, I cried. Not like a this powerless crying. I cried, why did you leave me and go to this wedding? To this function you went leaving me. Then they have to convince me that no, you are not born that time. I felt the lesson of impermanence has become part of my cognition. After that, even small, simple decisions, that impermanence has taken over me. When I was asked to go to school, I will tell, what is the use? I have to find something which is permanent. When I am asked to go eat, what is the use? I have to find something permanent. That impermanence has become my decision-making strategy. All of you are able to get it? Out of which I started making decisions in my life. That became part of my complete inner space cognition. See, all these things you should listen, 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 and that being should evolve. Then when you go into the process without a break, the experience is totally different. You understand? It's like in the 100th degree, water will become steam. The 100th degree has to happen continuously. You cannot make 99 degree, come on, leave it. After 10 minutes, I'll raise one more degree. Will that water become steam? That's what we are doing now. It has to be continuous listening. Now I tell you, with spirituality only that rawness gives that straight effect. The more you become civilized, more the strength of the spiritual experience is lost. First death taught me the lesson of impermanence. Are the translators, are you guys translating that word? Impermanence. Anityatva. Nirandaram illamai. The impermanence. That was a strong lesson I learned. I can say my very cognition has started functioning with that way. If somebody is building a house, if I see, I'll feel, ah, what is there? Anyhow, you are not going to be here. What for building the house? And somehow I got the fear that one day suddenly if the Arunachala temple is not there, what will happen to me? Because that was the place I grew up and that was the place I loved so much in my life. I went and asked my guru, yoga teacher, I asked him, will the temple disappear? He said, yes, at one day temple also will disappear, but God won't disappear. He is the only permanent thing, hold on to Him. But that lesson never sinked into me. Because that was not the mood. I was not ready to catch what is permanent. I was only cognizing impermanence is life. You understand? Please understand, I was not going for the solution or to catch something which is permanent. No. My cognition, I am telling you exactly as it happened in me. Later on I realized God is the only permanent thing and all that. But that time when He said, it did not click with me. Impermanent is the only thing. And I was only afraid that this beautiful temple which I play around, nobody should take it away.